We've spent the last year upgrading the electrical systems on various RVs with pre-existing electrical systems, and we've learned some stuff along the way that we want to share with all of you. Upgrading your electrical system in stages is a great way to save on upfront costs, starting with essentials like swapping your AGM or lead acid batteries to lithium batteries, and then upgrading solar charging, inverter capacity, and all that other kind of stuff will give you immediate performance results with room to grow into bigger and more performance systems. So in this video, we're going to show some tips to upgrading an RV electrical system in stages so that the amount of rework if you plan to add later on is minimal, which will save time and money.
The first step in giving your RV more power is to convert the lead acid or AGM batteries that it came with to lithium iron phosphate batteries like Battle Born batteries. Even if you just swap out the 1-2 AGM or lead acid batteries your RV came with to 1-2 lithium batteries in the factory location, you'll pretty much double your battery bank capacity because lithium batteries can be discharged all the way to 0% without sustaining any damage. Whereas a lead acid or AGM battery can only be discharged to 50% before the lifespan starts to be negatively impacted. The only real consideration here is to make sure that your factory converter, which is usually installed in or behind the breaker box, can be set up to charge lithium batteries. Most newer converters can do this, but if not, a new lithium compatible converter can be purchased for a couple $100. Now, if you want more batteries, you'll probably need to move your battery bank to a new location with more room and add a battery bank relocation kit like the one that we've shown in all of our start to finish RV electrical upgrade videos.
The battery monitor that comes pre-installed on most RVs is pretty inaccurate, especially after switching to lithium batteries, and adding a shunt-based monitor like the Victron Smart Shunt or the Victron BMB712 will be an immediate upgrade. Both of these literally count how many amps go into or out of the battery, and you can program the shunt with how many amp hours of capacity that you actually have in your battery bank. And this is going to be a much more accurate measurement than basing how full or empty the battery is based on the battery voltage alone, like the factory equipment usually does. Now, this is also a pretty inexpensive upgrade, with both the Smart Shunt and the BMB712 coming in at under $250 as of making this video. And the shunt simply gets installed between the negative battery terminal of the battery bank and all of the negative wires that were connected to the factory batteries.
Adding more solar charging capabilities to your RV is the next thing that we'd recommend adding to an RV electrical system with off-grid aspirations. After increasing the battery bank capacity, more solar will help recharge those higher capacity batteries quicker. The rule of thumb for solar array sizing is to have twice as many watts of solar as you do battery bank amp hours at 12 volts. For example, 200 watts of solar for a 100 amp hour 12 volt battery bank, 400 watts of solar for 200 amp hours of 12 volt batteries, or 600 watts of solar for 300 amp hours of 12 volt batteries. The only consideration here is to not add more solar than your batteries can charge at. For example, Battle Born batteries can charge at a max rate of 50 amps per 100 amp hour battery, which means don't add more than 700 watts of solar to only 100 amp hours of battery, or 1400 watts of solar to 200 amp hours of batteries, or 2100 watts of solar to only 300 amp hours of batteries. This is a pretty rare problem, but we have seen it before, so it's worth noting.
Most RVs don't have an inverter to turn the 12 volt DC power into 120 volt AC power for standard household outlet usage. And if they do, it's usually only for 1-2 outlets. Now, adding an aftermarket inverter charger like the Victron MultiPlus between the shore power inlet and the factory breaker box, like we've shown in all of our full system installs this year, will still allow you to recharge your batteries, but will also allow you to power all of your outlets from those batteries. If the inverter and battery bank is large enough, you can even start to consider using large electrical components like an air conditioner. But be aware that air conditioner usage is going to require a very large, and therefore very expensive, battery bank with enough solar to recharge. The main considerations here are that a big enough battery bank is necessary for various sizes of inverters. In general, a 2,000 watt inverter requires a minimum of 200 amp hours of battery bank capacity. A 3,000 watt inverter requires a minimum of 400 amp hours of battery bank capacity. And a 5,000 watt inverter requires a minimum of 800 amp hours of battery bank capacity, which also goes to a 24 volt system. The other considerations here is that Victron only makes an inverter charger appropriate for 50 amp shore power in one size, as of making this video anyway. So if you only have 200 amp hours of battery bank capacity, there really isn't a good option for the appropriately sized 2000 watt inverter, and you're going to need to step up to 400 amp hours of battery to get the MultiPlus 3K 2X120. The last consideration here is that when you're using big inverters like these, upgrading wiring, fusing, and DC distribution is going to be necessary by adding a Lynx distributor to your system. There's still tape up here. Okay.
And the last step in a high-end RV electrical system upgrade is to upgrade the alternator charging from the 2 to 3 amps coming from the 7-pin connector to 30 plus amps. Now this involves adding a DC to DC charger like the Victron Orion, and then running dedicated positive and negative wires from the Lynx distributor to the engine starting battery. If you have a towable RV like a travel trailer or fifth wheel, you'd want to use Anderson connectors for the hitch connection, and we have those options available in our kits at shop.explorers.life. Upgrading alternator charging will ensure you arrive to your campsite with a full battery, but upgraded alternator charging isn't for everybody. Remember that your solar will continue to charge even while you're driving. We made a separate video for those of you on the fence about upgrading your alternator charging, and you can check that out here. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Yawn as soon as you. New lithium compatible converter can be, dang it.
Compatible?
Compatible. Lithium compatible, I said it again.
System on the negative wires. Why did I change that? That didn't make any sense. Just read what it says. It's pretty good.
Are you recording right now?
Okay. I didn't hear the ding.